Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to the Lobotomy Corporation. We are ready to go here for the real test. Now that we have Gabura back in the disciplinary team, we are now subject to meltdowns, and our maximum ordeal has now gone up to midnight. So for those of you who are unfamiliar with what any of that means, just to give you a really quick overview, but I suggest watching season one first. I know that's kind of a cop-out answer, but it's the truth because there's so much to explain. Basically, every time that we reset the meltdown counter, the counter that goes, you know, the one in the top left-hand corner up here, usually that means that we're going to be forced to work on abnormalities that are melting down. If we do not work on them, the clip-off counter reaches zero. And then if they escape at zero, for example, then they will get out, or something bad will happen if they have some sort of contingency whenever, or some sort of stipulation if their counter hits zero. Now, the reason why that's a big deal is because we have an abnormality that we're unfamiliar with and we just don't know. So that's why we've hired Rob, good old Robert. He's back, Alpaca Patrol. He's going to be dealing with a new abnormality, and if he dies, well, he wasn't very good anyway. But again, I highly suggest you go watch the first season if you want to learn all about meltdowns and why they are so difficult to deal with. We've been blessed up until now because we have actually suppressed all the Sapphira, going from the control team all the way down to the central command team 1 and 2. But we are now getting into the part of the game where we have not done that for these other departments, which means that they are subject to meltdowns. So it's about to change. The game is about to change. Here we go. What is that? Is that Mimikyu? I feel like we've seen this one before. Okay, so it looks like it's an HE. Whoops. Alright, Rob. Well, I have a feeling this is going to be animalistic, so we're going to let Rob check it out first. I don't like the sound it's making. I'm pretty sure that we've seen this one before. Its nest appears to form a wet and sleek sphere. It's not unreasonable to mistake Rob's brain as a nest. What? When Rob's skin becomes hazy green, it's already too late. Oh, yeah! This is the one where, like, we basically just said we're not going to be dealing with this one. That's right. Well, unfortunately, we're going to have to deal with this one. It's a Vav. Okay. The Naked Nest deals red damage. When you spot any employee whose face is turning dark green, please report them to the fire in each department immediately. Please be advised to verify the cause of the discoloration is not just a simple stomach ache. When advised to visit the medical ward, those with a stomach ache would agree, but the infected employee will still try to act like nothing was wrong. If so, don't alert the employee that anything's out of the ordinary. When the host becomes agitated, the infection will speed up. If the skin begins to change, then 30% of the brain has already been consumed. Any conversation at this point will be done by the abnormality, so don't pay it any mind. The abnormality that is residing inside the host's frontal lobe, and the host will not feel any physical sensations. You can try stabbing the employee with something sharp, feigning as a mistake, but this is not recommended. As mentioned before, the host is already a part of the abnormality around 30%, so conversing with it will be impossible. Yeah, I semi-remember what this one is. The Naked Nest appeared. Yeah, it did. So hopefully we don't see Rob getting infected here. We're not sure if he is or not. I'm sure the game will tell us. Rob, you doing all right? He looks okay. Observation result that concluded that employees with low HP are more susceptible to the Naked Nest special ability while working. In particular, taking higher damage during work raises the probability of skill activation. Some of the employees suffering from the phenomenon had the following symptoms: green skin and rash on the body, drastically reduced movement speed. If any of the symptoms mentioned above are seen on any employee mentioned above, remove them immediately. I mean, Rob looks like he's still okay, so We're gonna let it go one more time here. So the more damage that Rob takes, the more susceptible he is, but he's still doing okay. Still good, I think. You okay, Rob? Is his movement hindered in any way? Doesn't look like it. After leaving Mason, who was suffering the symptoms mentioned above for a certain time, the employee changed into a form similar to the naked nest, hereby called, well, patient zero, patient one. Warning, any employee that have been in contact with the infected employee prior to them turning into the host will be likely infected as well. All employees in the department section must be observed for any symptoms mentioned in Management Rule 2. The naked serpent can enter any hole of your body. This does not mean covering up your orifices will impede it from entering. Happy Halloween, everyone. Happy Thanksgiving. Merry Christmas, by the way. So we know that there's going to be one meltdown coming up next because, well, it says... So this is the meltdown counter. This will show how many departments will be melting down once the meltdown counter reaches the end here. Now, up to this point, we haven't had to worry about that. But that's soon going to change. Alright, Blue Star. You know what, Jazzy Dubs? I'm gonna give you a chance to move up to the big league, son. Instinct, Darvain, Plague Doctor's down here. We gotta remember that. Vaynar, no, we'll let Cage Drifter go. I kind of want to work the King of Greed to get more gloves, but I also kind of don't want to. I'm going to get me that mask, don't worry. Addo can go ahead and work with Darebro. Husky. Coach Krendor. And Stupid Bird. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, it doesn't matter. We know which meltdown is going to be, so it's going to be down here. Okay, so this is what the meltdown counter looks like. So we have 69 seconds to get in here and complete any work. It could be any work, and it will reset the meltdown counter. But now, just imagine, this may not seem all that hard to those of you who've not seen this game before. But keep in mind that at one point, all of these sections would melt down at some point, and it's completely random, so you don't know who you're going to have to work. And if it lands on someone who you would not want there to be any sort of meltdown with, I'm not going to say who, but just for example, if it happened to land on an abnormality you did not want to work with, then that's when the fun really begins. I say fun loosely. Doing great, Rob. Keep it up. Uncover those orifices. Does it escape? It's not escape. The gift is shed skin. HP 5, SP 5. That's not bad. It will help ease your mind if you cover up as much as possible. The naked serpent's final destination is your frontal lobe. You'll become the serpent's nest, attacking anything in its sight. Uh-huh. Well, not Rob. Rob will be fine. He'll be fine. He won't turn hideously green. It's Rob. He lives in the trash. He was born in the trash. Diseases do not affect him. Okay, so common are instinct and attachment. I'm going to stick with instinct just because that's the one that's been working. sound you're hearing is Punishing Bird, by the way. Good job, Rob. Rob's still looking healthy, for all intents and purposes. The weapon is Shed Skin. What? But what is it? But what is that, though? It's a ranged, it's a gun of some sort, but, alright. Please understand, if you become a nest, you'll be forced to we will be forced to shoot you on sight and burn your corpse. Agreed. It's a skin cannon, I guess. Which is the name of my punk band back in high school. We were called the Skin Cannon. Rob. Rob's still looking good. Alright, well, we don't have to worry about the Naked Nest anymore for a while. Alright, so we got Crimson Dawn coming up. Maynard. Blue Star. Was that okay for you, Jazzy Dubs? Looks like it was. Yeah. Repression, we'll let Addo go. I'm still gonna get my Mountain Mask eventually. Maggie. Here we go for little Daisy. We're gonna wait until everyone gets out, and then we're gonna go after the Crimson Dawn. We'll let Addo go work with Darebro. So here comes the Crimson Dawn. No problem. They've all split up. One near. One up here. All right, team, get to it. I don't think we lost any employees. So we really don't need to work on Crimson Dawn anymore, like, at all. I mean, it's nice that there's, like, a cannon there, but, like, I don't really want the skin cannon. I'd prefer if the skin cannon stayed as far away from my skin as possible. I really want to work the King Agreed. Let's work the King Agreed once. Surely it'll be okay. Let's let Maggie do it. Maggie. Come on, Maggie. Man, Maggie with the dunk. She get the glove? No, she did not. Okay. It's okay. It was a good try, Maggie. It's a good try. Do it again. I'll get the skin cannon because I'm pretty sure people want to at least know what it shoots. It's probably like a... It's just a clump of... like dead skin, probably. If I know Lobotomy Corporation like I do, it's probably just a lump of dead skin. Stupid Bird. So this one again is melting down because it's the only one that can, and we've already got it taken care of. So Rob's gonna have to do it one more time here. Starvane with the repression. Let's have Addo work with Darebro. Maggie get the glove? She did not. One more time. One more time, Maggie. I have faith in Maggie. And now we have to wait for Punishing Bird to come back. We can also use Lili down here for attachments. Dude, Force has been crushing it with Sensor. There, we have the skin, the shed skin cannon, whatever you want to call it. Now we don't have to go to Crimson Noon, and I'm actually kind of leaning towards we shouldn't. It's not that we can't do Crimson Noon, it's just why even risk it at this point? We've already got all the power. Everyone's pretty much rank 5, except for Rob. Right now, we're kind of going through the motions just to see if we can get some extra ego gifts from the Alephs. So once Punishing Bird goes back to its containment unit, we'll probably end the day here. And Rob still looks like he's okay. I don't see any stat downs or anything. Jazzy Dubs. I mean, people are surprisingly doing a good job against Blue Star. Blue Star is not the easiest admirality. In fact, it's one of the most dangerous ones. And we've been crushing it, so good job, team. Good job, team. We should have some pretty good gains there. I'm not going to go fight Crimson Dew. There's no reason to. Husky got a little bit of a gain. Lili worked a little bit on Temperance, so did a little Daisy. Math has got a Fortitude upgrade slightly. Darvane with big gains. Oh my goodness, Jazzy Dubs got 30 SP from working with Blue Star. 30. Holy smokes, Jazzy Dubs. Addo got a rank 5 increase to Justice. Good gains there for Cajun Drifter. Rob already is rank 5. He had a 50 HP increase. Good lord, Rob. I'd say that was pretty good. But now is when things get tricky. No, that's Liluna. So for those of you who don't know the backstory of this is a Kickstarter abnormality that uses a copyrighted track that got copyright flagged on my channel the last time we saw it. The developer's official stance was that we don't care. So, they said and they didn't say we don't care. They said just replace the track. Like, replace the part of the video. It's like, or I could just not take it ever again. Little Prince Silent Orchestra. I wouldn't mind having Silent Orchestra back, but I don't want to. Ooh, okay. Ices are melting. Not ice is melting, but ices. Ices are melting. We don't know if it's because spring is coming or the palace is crumbling. We know what melting love is. The only advice that can be given is to be cautious and be aware of your surroundings. The palace is crumbling. In our world, the mind is nothing anymore. Everything is advancing, but the human mind is too slow to catch up. All that remains are the 26 singularities and the ones tied to them. Humankind deserted their former beliefs and now do not respect the various things which were supporting us. Now, no one ever dreams, never believes in something, or desires anything. The belief once strong within somebody is now obsolete and worthless. Everything has gone quiet as if nothing happened in the first place. But A couldn't stand the silence. So what do you think happened to A? I can tell you because I'm standing right here. Ah! On a bright sunny day, he died. I was both the first witness of his death and one of the culprits of his murder. But A has been existing here, and he has been watching you ever since you stepped inside. Sometimes Sapphires would ask me this. Why do we have to bear this pain? Machines should exist only as a tool for specified work. But why do we have the knowledge of... Why do we have to know the agony of loss, obsessions, hope, and despair? I thought I couldn't answer anything, but even I... Not even I could answer that. A machine must behave like a machine. Something that A told me often. Perhaps A, who would know better than anyone, made us like this because it's all but a puppet show for him. You seem to have no idea. Of course, there's no way for you to know. But it's time for you to know the answer. Some quality lines right there. It's something I've always done. First is hope. Second is agony. Third is pain. Fourth is anxiety. Fifth is distrust. Now nothing remains. Okay. Well, there you go. Oh, hey, we're back. All right, everyone. Well, that's going to do it. We've got 18 lobotomy points. We probably will need to shuffle someone over to work with Rob in the disciplinary team. But again, if you've been enjoying the Lobotomy Corporation series, continue clicking on the like button. Subscribe, of course, if you want to get notified when my newest videos do go live. Also, ring the notification bell to have a higher chance of that happening. Although with YouTube, who freaking knows anymore? As a quick reminder, Lobotomy Corporation does not run over the weekend, but it'll be back on Monday, and we'll continue our adventures here. Thank you again, everyone, sincerely, for all of the support on the Lobotomy Corporation series here in Season 2. And things are really starting to take off now because we're going to be getting into Sapphira departments that we have not suppressed yet. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!